Please click on the subscribe button to follow my channel, and please click on the bell icon to get all notifications about my future videos. This R15 V3 is completely different from the R15 V2. Here we get lot of changes in this bike. This is completely next generation of the R15. This bike gets 155cc liquid cooled 4-valve SOHC engine, which churns out the power of 19.4 PS at 10,000 RPM and 15 Nm of torque at 8,000 RPM. These power ratios are very high for an 150cc bike, so this bike's performance is quite amazing. Now this bike gets complete LED unit headlamps and also tail lamps. It also gets variable valve action functionality, which activates after 7000 RPM, and it increases the performance of the bike from that RPM level. Due to its riding dynamics, we have got the complete potential of this bike from its engine. Since it is a track machine and definitely made for the track purpose, its riding dynamics are too aggressive, so we have to completely lean down in front to reach the handlebar, and it may create back pains or shoulder pains in the long rides. I personally love the exhaust note of this bike, so let me show you some clip of exhaust note. Okay guys, now let's check the top speed of R15 V3. Since the road is too dark, I couldn't able to make more speeds, but definitely R15 is capable to reach speed up to 150 km/h.
The top speed I could able to reach in this bike is 144. This bike can go more, but during this night time I can't able to go more speeds because of the traffic. Also my friend who is on the FC25 also followed me, and he tried to do the top speed. Let's see what he is telling now. Have you reached top speed?
140.
Yeah,
wobbling.
Bike started wobbling.
Yeah.
Okay. You should be careful in the FZ25 during the top speeds, because it is not designed for cruising through the air. It may start wobbling, but R15 is completely designed by aerodynamics, so it can cruise through the air without any problem. That is the different guys. Even R15 can test the same top speed as much as FZ25 do. R15 can do even more. But the thing is, in any other short drag races, FZ25 can win the race any day, because its pickup is simply awesome.
I have also made a drag race between FZ25 and R15 V3, and I will upload that video very soon. So please subscribe to my channel and stay tuned for that video, guys. And my final verdict about this bike is, if you are a daily commuter and if you travel in bikes more than 50 kilometers per day, then definitely this bike is not for you, because it will definitely create back pain or shoulder pain for you. If your daily riding usage is less than 25 km and if you are practicing for the track races, then you can definitely go for this bike. It will definitely improve your riding skills. Then according to the fuel meter in this bike, it gives more than 45 kmpl, but we need to check the mileage in the daily usage. It may reduce due to the traffics. So guys, as I said before, I have done the drag race between FZ25 and R15 V3. I will upload that video real soon. So please subscribe to my channel and stay tuned, guys. Meet you guys in another vlog. Take care. Bye-bye. Please click on the subscribe button to follow my channel. And please click on the bell icon to get all notification about my future videos.